Coming up next on Jonathan Bird's Blue World, the kelp forests of Southern California.
Hi, I'm Jonathan Bird, and welcome to my world. Harold Parker State Forest in Massachusetts. It looks like a typical forest, but not all forests are the same.
I'm heading to Catalina Island off the coast of California to explore another kind of forest.
Here the forests are underwater.
Getting here from the mainland is as easy as boarding a ferry. 90 minutes later, we arrive in Avalon, one of only two settlements on Catalina Island. I head on over to Catalina Scuba Love Dive Shop and pick up some scuba tanks. Then, it's off to Casino Point for a shore dive. Casino Point is a beautiful spot just outside the harbor. It's also a marine reserve, so no fishing is allowed. I waste no time and start suiting up to explore this dive site that has such a great reputation. Casino Point is set up as a dive park with a protected area just for divers, safe from boat traffic.
And look, a staircase right into the water.
I walk down the steps and descend into the Pacific Ocean. Immediately, I am greeted by blue water, excellent visibility, and lots of kelp. And now I know why they call these places kelp forests. The kelp grows up from the seafloor as tall as trees. I really do feel like I'm in a forest. Kelp is a kind of marine algae that can take many forms. The kelp forests around Catalina Island are formed by giant kelp, which can reach the height of a 14-story building in only a single growing season because it can grow 2 feet a day. It's one of the fastest growing organisms on Earth. Looking down at it from above, I see what an eagle might see flying over the trees in a forest. But unlike trees on land, the kelp doesn't have a rigid trunk to hold it up. In fact, the kelp is quite floppy. So how does it stay vertical? At the base of each leaf, called a frond, is a pneumaticyst, basically a little gas bladder. Each one of these pneumaticysts provides buoyancy, so the kelp floats. Down on the seafloor is something called a holdfast. Basically, it's like a set of roots that hold onto the rocks. Kelp needs something heavy on which to attach itself. It can't grow in a sandy seafloor. So, between the nematocysts keeping it afloat and the holdfast keeping it from floating away, the kelp hangs vertically in the water. Kelp is really important in this ecosystem because it's a great place to hide. And I don't mean for divers. This is a great habitat for fish to seek refuge from predators, so the kelp forest is filled with thousands of fish. The most famous kelp forest resident in Southern California is most certainly this damselfish, the Garibaldi. Garibaldis are hard to miss. No other fish in the kelp forest is quite so brightly colored. Although Garibaldis become aggressive when they're guarding a nest of eggs, the rest of the time they don't seem bothered by divers much. In fact, this one seems positively curious. Thank you. I find it hard to film the kelp because every time I settle down to get a shot, a Garibaldi pokes its head in to see what I'm up to. So I film the curious fish for a few minutes, only to discover a whole bunch of other fish watching the show. It seems I've become quite popular down here. Because lots of divers come to this site, these kelp bass are not afraid. They must know that there's no fishing allowed in this sanctuary. They pose confidently for my camera. Nearby, I also find a turbid snail. These snails move up and down the stipe of the kelp, munching away on the algae. All this munching is making me hungry, so as my tank gets low, I turn around and head back to the steps. Time for some lunch. The following morning, I board the Catalina Scuba Love boat King Neptune. We're heading out to visit a different kelp site in hopes of finding some additional residents of the kelp forest. We leave Avalon Harbor under a beautiful blue sky. Only half an hour from the dock, I prepare to dive. The water's in the mid-60s, so a 7mm wetsuit will keep me nice and warm. I hop into the water from the dive boat's convenient submerged swim step, and Julia hands me my camera. I descend into the blue and soon enter another mysterious kelp forest. I head out deeper to a sandy slope where there isn't much substrate for the kelp. At a depth of 90 feet, we discover a rare resident of the kelp forest, a torpedo ray. I move a piece of kelp so I can get in close for a shot. The ray is not afraid of me because she has a powerful means of defense, electricity. This animal generates an electrical charge of nearly 50 volts that it can use to zap predators or its prey. The torpedo ray has a curious looking tail, unlike most other rays. I want to see her swim so I can film the tail, so I give her a little tickle. The ray immediately turns around and faces off against my camera. I wasn't expecting such an aggressive reaction, so I keep my camera between the two of us and we stare each other down. I'm not making any sudden moves, and neither is she. But as cameraman Todd moves in closer for a shot and inadvertently closes her avenue for escape, the torpedo ray panics and attacks my camera, pulsing the muscles in her abdomen that create electricity. Then, as quickly as it began, she calls off the attack and swims away. I follow along behind, and now I can see how she swishes her tail back and forth to swim like her relative, the shark, much different from how other rays swim. What a way to end an incredible couple of days diving Catalina Island. These beautiful forests of kelp and their colorful inhabitants truly are one of the many wonders of the blue world.